Alright, so I've got this set up with 9 volts instead of this 5 volt DC. So it should be a bit quicker. As you can see, it's already starting to work. I don't know if you can see that. Anyway, there's bubbles on the surface. So I've got the anode, sacrificial piece of steel. Doesn't have little lenses, but yeah, it's better. So I'll come back. I don't know when, but I'll come back. I'm trying to see, is that even the right way around? I might have my polarity wrong, but no, I'll come back. Should work anyway. Yeah, so come back when this is done, flip it around, and then yeah. Alright, so what I've done is I put the clamp in and I realised that it didn't fit, which I was expecting that to happen, and so I filled it up with some more water. I also put in some degreaser. Believe it or not, it's amazing at cleaning off anything, like, well, grease obviously, but dirt, rust, it just helps clean up parts, and yeah, it's just amazing. I put the anode in, which is just like an old, like, saw blade. These are made for, hacksaws, but they're terrible blades. They're, like, used for, if you want to, like, completely hack something up. This was, like, bent and rusted and worn out anyway, so I sanded off the paint on that end, and I sanded off the paint, the rust at this end where the positive wire connects to. And I think, like, it's amazing because it has that hole there, it's just perfect, you know, and I can bend it real easy so it fits the bucket, and it goes right down into the water the full, you know, full way. I have to switch this around once it's done one side, but yeah, I'll come back once everything's hooked up and I'll leave it, and yeah. Alright, so I found this old adjustable clamp in the garage, and it was in a box of tools that they were in a, like, a really dry spot, and then they got moved and they got put right under a drip, and then the bucket, like, we had a massive storm and the bucket just filled up with water, at least, like, I don't know, 4 or 5 centimeters of water, and so these tools mostly got all rusty, and most of them aren't in too much, you know, they're not in amazing quality. So I thought that today I might chuck this in the electrolysis bath and see what happens, because this is quite a big clamp, as you can see, and it wouldn't fit in any other bucket, so I had to, you know, fill this up, like, just with a little bit of water, enough to go over the top, and I haven't actually tested if this fits, so I might have to redo this, but I've got to wind it in all the way so I can have maximum, you know, space. See, it's bubbling away there. Anybody who's watched my other video on electrolysis will know that this is sodium bicarbonate. You should really use sodium carbonate, but since it's not as conductive, I put salt in there, which is a, you know, general fact that salt is, you know, it makes water really conductive. So I'm gonna, I'll get this hooked up to the 9 volts, that I'll just run off the circuit breaking, the power guard outlet in there, and then I'll put it in the tank. I've just got the angle grinder out here, but I'm not going to be using it in this video, but I mean bench grinder, because I don't have a wire wheel, but you know. Yeah, so yeah, I'll chuck this in the electrolysis bath. I might leave it in for a bit longer. This was actually almost to the point where I couldn't wind it, but I used some CRC penetrating oil. This is the marine grade stuff, so it's super strong, and it's just started raining. Anyway, yeah, so I use this, and yeah, it's freed up quite a bit, but still, you know, I want to get this all nice and ready, because these clamps, this type of clamp is amazing for use loads of these and work on like motorbikes and stuff. Because you know, they're just really, really small and compact. I mean, this is one of the bigger ones, but still, you know, it doesn't have a massive handle and big, you know. Yeah, they're just really handy. So I could get a new one for super cheap, but yeah. So I'll get this hooked up and I'll come back once that's done. Okay, so I'm back with another update on this clamp that I was doing. So I left it in the electrolysis bath around, I left it in there for 3 days, but I think it got unplugged, so it was probably like 2 days of actually, like, with electricity actually running through it. And then because I was away and I came back to look at it, because I came back home, first thing I did is I looked at it, and some copper from the wires had actually fallen in into the solution, and that's like, I don't know if anybody knows, but that's like a big no-no when you're doing electrolysis. It just makes a big mess, everything goes all, there's like bits just hanging off this, it was all green, and I don't know if anybody knows that copper smell, but it reeked of copper, which is like, it's one of the grossest smells that I've ever smelled in my life. But yeah. So after that I cleaned it all off, which was disgusting, and then I used this wire brush to just get all the gunk off. Then I kept washing it with water. Washed it with some warm water and soap and stuff, got it all clean. Then just today I started doing some sanding on it, so I went from 40 grit to 120. And then 140, I think this is 240, I'm not sure. I sanded it all down, got all the rust off, well, as much as I could. And then sprayed it with CRC 66, which is, as you can see, prevents rust, drives out moisture, frees corroded parts, and yeah. So I sprayed it with that, which is what you usually do to your tools once you're finished destroying them. Some people don't, some people just leave them because they have a nice big dry workshop, but the workspace I'll be working in will have quite a bit of moisture in it, so I'll just do this anyway. It's just a bit of protection. So I completely coated this, and I've had it sitting for about an hour, so right now I'll probably clean it off, respray it, and then clean it off straight after that. I won't let it sit. Now I'll just grease up all of this, get it, you know, working nicely, and yeah, then I should be done. I can't wait to leave this town, cause daily I've been feeling down. The cold nights just don't feel the same. Oh, pack my life inside a car, hit the road and drive real far. Put that record on me, dark. Oh, ooh, I'm dreaming of you. I dream of a new life. All right. So I've finished wiping off all the CRC from this, and I put another coat on, and then wiped off, as you can see. But I was about to run out of this, and there's still stuff in it, but you can't really get that out. So I was about to run out. And what you do is, if you crush the can, Just make sure that these creases don't make holes in the can. But if you crush it, it pushes out all the air. It gives it, you know, less space for the air, and it pressurizes it more. So, you know, you can just kind of, not much use now, but yeah, it's just a tip that I got from my friend. So yeah, so next I'm gonna completely wipe this down because it's got paint on it. As you can see, it's got paint there and there's some swatches there. I'm just gonna wipe down all the stuff that's on this with so I've got some kerosene outside or some tabs, I can't remember. I've got, there's loads of stuff, I'll just go check. And you know, I'll just wipe it down, make it all nice and, you know, presentable. And then yeah, then I'll grease it up using this multi-purpose grease that I got. So yeah. Alright, so I finished the cleaning of this and it's all greased and ready to be used. I was thinking of highlighting this engravement here. You should put paint over it and you can like wipe it off and it highlights the, you know, the letters. So I was thinking of doing that. But this is pretty much ready for use, you know. It looks like it's still rusty, but that's just a black rust that got converted during the kind of failure of an electrolysis process. But I've just got it on this piece of paper so I don't get any grease on the desk, because it's still, you know, your tools will eventually, all the grease will dry out, that's, you know, kind of on here and stuff, so you can pick it up without getting your hands all greasy. But at the moment it's still got grease on it, so I'm just going to leave it like this, just like, you know, on the handle and stuff all around there. So I'll just let that set, you know. But yeah, this is ready for use. These are great when you're working on motorbikes, because, you know, I will be working on a motorbike in the future. I'm going to have a video coming up about that. But yeah. So, I will be back once I've done this highlighting, show you the results. It's probably not going to be that good, but, you know, yeah. Alright, so just about to start painting. I've got some leather strips. You can use a soft side for painting. I've found that they're really, really useful. I could use a paintbrush, but it's just some of the bristles, you know, you'll catch a bit of paint on there, you go to wipe it off, you just smudge the whole thing. So I find that these are actually easier. So I've got some red paint here that I found in my box. I don't know, it's pretty good paint, but yeah, I've just got a box of old art stuff. So I am gonna do this. Currently watching Jake the Garden Snake's video on his Supermoto build, as you can see. Ooh. Big projects coming for the future. Anyway, yeah, so I'll come back once this is painted, and then I'll show you the final results once everything's dried up later tonight. So I'm making this video on Sunday, so technically it's another video for this week. But it's probably going to come out on like Tuesday. Well, you're probably going to see it on Tuesday, so yeah. Alright, so I've now finished this. It's fully complete. I did the highlighting for the name. I'm gonna get some better lighting in here. Yeah, we're gonna move this lamp over. This is still shit, but whatever. So yeah, I've highlighted the name. I went around the outside, got all that paint cleaned up. It turned out quite good. But I'm gonna have to clean up this a bit more because I cleaned off all the grease before and I touched it again. It's still there, so gonna have to make sure that's all cleaned up. But yeah, that's not really needed. I can pretty much, you know, start using this now. Yeah, so if you enjoyed that video, remember to like, subscribe, share it, comment what you want to see next, and click the notification bell so that you know when I get that, so that you get notified when I upload. Yeah.